ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming to the senior play tonight. Parents just don't understand. We've had a good several shows. The kids have done a nice job of memorizing their lines. Last night, I have to tell you, we had a couple Carol Burnett moments with the kids cracking each other up. So that truly makes for a fun show because we get to laugh with them. Hopefully that won't happen tonight. I will tell you, the man that wrote this, Brian Starchman, he is a high school teacher. And he writes a play about once every other year, and he writes them for his own kids. I really like them. He writes well for this age group, and he writes well for the audiences. All of us of a specific age, we get the jokes that he's putting in there. So please laugh loud, laugh often, and laugh early, because the kids have done a nice job putting together Parents Just Don't Understand.
Is this thing catered?
What? I didn't eat breakfast.
Would you really want to eat dinner to buy more dishes?
Good point. Can we hit on Mickey D's on the way home?
Would you give it a rest and focus on why we're here?
Why are we here?
To pay our respects. It's what good family members do.
Explain to me again how related your Aunt Beulah.
Well, she is my mother's mother's sister.
You mean was?
What? You always cracked my grammar.
Can I be excused from the table?
I don't know. Can you? Are you capable of being excused? I mean, may I? Or when I ask to be?
Will you be quiet? Anyway, you're saying your Aunt Beulah is your mother's mother?
Actually, I thought she was my father's mother's sister.
Are you sure? I'm pretty sure she's from my side.
I never met her, but I'm almost positive she's from my side.
What if she's from both your sides? You are related. Ew!
I think I'm gonna throw up.
She's not from both our sides. We're just confused. Things get complicated when you come from a large family.
We're just not sure which side Fredella is from.
Then why are we here?
Pay our respects to a woman you never even met. I mean, I'm basically missing a valuable Sunday afternoon television viewing to pay my respects to a total stranger.
She's not a stranger.
Oh, cool! Open casket!
Get back here!
Well, at least he's showing interest. What?
Was Lily Abu a Methodist like us, or what?
She was a Christian.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure.
I mean, you never met her, so she could be atheist. Then she had to be buried in a certain type of cemetery, and
why are you so curious now? You never want to come to church with us anyways.
I just want to make a conversation. Sheesh.
Mom, have you ever seen a picture of Grandma Bula?
Of course. We have one hanging up with all the local neighbors.
I thought so. And in that picture, was she wearing an eye patch with a pair of well-groomed mutton chops?
What are you saying?
And I know fashions have changed lately, but would she be the kind of lady that would wish to be buried in a black leather jacket with a motorcycle helmet tucked under her hands?
Oh my gosh. We're at the wrong way.
Thank you for coming to Bubba's Wake. The Flame from Eagle Marks Light Game appreciates your attendance. We got sticky up, brothers. Right. Your old ladies are needed way outside. It's for the men only. But don't worry. Just because Bubba Killer's still loose doesn't mean it won't be safe. You both brought your guns, right? Okay. Deep breaths.
Cool. I got A, driver's ed. I'm ready for this.
That was a class based solely on a book. I can pass a class on how to drive a spatial, but it would be completely different once I got behind the steering wheel.
Do spatials even have steering wheels?
I don't know. That's not the point. The point is...
I know! This is the real deal. Everything's gonna be fine, Dad. You taught me how to ride my bike. You taught me how to cook scrambled eggs. You're a great teacher. This is gonna be fine.
Thank you. I feel much calmer. Now, what is the first thing you do once you've entered the vehicle?
Am I gonna be zipped?
No, you do not check for zits. This is not the first thing you do when entering the vehicle. Actually, you do look a little red mark between your eyebrows.
I knew it! Mirror pictures are in like 3 days!
Stop. Just stop. Now, what is the first thing you do once you've entered the vehicle? Uncle Bay, your E say, El Bay.
Excuse me?
Uncle Bay, your E say, El Bay.
Dad, are you okay?
Uncle Bay, your E say, help it.
Mom, come quick. Dad's having a stroke.
I am not having a stroke. I'm speaking in Latin.
You know I'm speaking Spanish, right? Not Latin.
I'm trying to give you a hint.
By speaking in gibberish?
Buckle your seatbelt.
Oh, duh. What's next?
Can't do this. I cannot do this. You're not ready. I know how to get out of a car.
Dad, I know this is stressful, but I just found out the block a few times. Besides, I've got my seatbelt adjusted, and look, now I'm checking my mirrors.
Good. Very good.
Just shut your door and let's get started.
Alright. Now I want you to turn the key, shift it to drive, and ever so slightly, I want you to push down the gas and...
The brakes! Hit the brakes!
Where are the brakes?
Next to the gas!
Why are we stopping?
One foot!
Black is the absence of color.
That's what I'm talking about. It's so depressing.
Life is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. William Shakespeare.
For every one of us that succeeds, it's because there's somebody there to show you the way out. Oprah Winfrey.
Yeah. Totally the same stratosphere as Willie.
Don't call Shakespeare Willie.
Oh, sorry, you're right. You might hear me and get offended. If his body had already been eaten by maggots 400 years ago.
I just think a little color would perk you up.
I'm perky. See?
There has got to be something in here.
If it makes you feel any better, one time in art class, I mixed all the paint colors together, and eventually it turned to black. So, like, technically, I'm a walking rainbow.
Rainbows don't hang crosses upside down over their beds.
It was a joke. I was just trying to freak you out.
Well, mission accomplished, young man. Ooh, what about this one?
It's got boats on it and comes with a sailor's hat. I'm going to high school, not audition for the village people.
Alright, what about this one?
That V-neck is so deep, I'll be showing off my belly button.
Or a sharp little baseball cap?
Because you know how I love you some sports, Simon.
A turtleneck?
That could work. I like a garment that's designed to slowly choke you throughout the day.
No, never mind. No turtlenecks. You know what? I give up. You want to look like the Prince of Darkness? Go right ahead.
Hey, what about this?
No, I'm done. I don't need any more smart aleck remarks.
No, I'm being totally serious. It's got the school zipper, it matches our school colors so I can wear it on pep rally days. This is a great sweater.
You actually like it?
Yeah, it's exactly what I want. But it's a little expensive though.
No, it's not. It's not black. You like it? We're buying it.
Man, that is one ugly sweater. But sometimes you gotta let them win. Besides, I only have to wear it out the front door. As soon as I get on the bus, that puppy's getting shoved in my backpack.
Good one.
You just don't understand me. That's because you never want to talk to me.
Oh, I want to talk. You're just too busy lecturing.
That's not true.
And we have nothing in common. Sometimes I wonder if I'm adopted.
Oh, trust me. You're mine whether you like it or not. You gave me morning sickness for 6 months. It was miserable.
Oh, so now you're blaming that on me too? Like, in the womb, I was already trying to get on your nerves?
That's not what I said. How could you think you were adopted? We almost look like twins.
Just because you try to dress like you're still a teenager doesn't make us twins.
Hey, that happens in society, baby. But that's not the point. We do what we like. We have the same ears.
Yeah, thanks a lot for that attribute, giant Dumbo ears.
They're small and classically beautiful. Great use of instruments. Don't get smart with me.
Would you rather I get dumb with you?
Seriously, don't be such a smart Alex.
My name is Brittany.
I know your name is Brittany. I'm the one that named you.
Then why did you just call me Alex?
I didn't. I called you a smart Alex.
Well, I'm a smart Brittany. I think what you meant to say was smart Alec.
You're skating on thin ice, you have crossed the line, and you're about to break the camel's back.
Mixed metaphors.
Where did you get this attitude at?
And a dangling preppy And my DVD player? Gladly. Stop. I changed my mind. I am shocked. Go to the basement. What? Why? You're being punished. Go to the basement. But there's nothing down there but moldy old boxes, and it smells like my soup. That's the point. I want you to think about what you've done. But I haven't done anything. You've disrespected me. Go. But how long do I have to until I come get you? Move it, Missy. I can't wait until I turn 18. Because look out, world. I'm so out of here. She's going to be 18 in less than a year, and I just want her to be ready to face the world. It all started this afternoon when she turned into this rabid she-beast and was like, you can't go to the movies with your boyfriend Todd until you've cleaned every square inch of your room. It all started this afternoon when I brought her some clean sheets. I suggested that she make her bed before going out to see a movie with her boyfriend Todd, so I knew she'd be getting home late and wouldn't want to make the bed in the middle of the night. And she hates my boyfriend Todd. I mean, she's always picking on his appearance. Her boyfriend Todd is lovely. He seems like a real gentleman. And the last time he was over, he had just gotten a sharp haircut. I made sure to compliment him on it. So when I told her I wasn't going to clean my room, she blew up. I couldn't understand why she wouldn't want to make the bed. I calmly explained to her that it would only take 5 minutes. I mean, I had already done the hard part. I'd washed the sheets. I did all her laundry for her. She's always doing things for me and then throwing it back in my face. Like the laundry. I would do my own laundry, but she doesn't trust me. I prefer to do the laundry because she doesn't listen to my instructions. One time, she threw her red sweatshirt into a load of white. I had just bought my husband green packages of underwear, and they turned pink. Just because Dad's tight whities turned pink once when I was 12, she won't let me near her precious washing machine. I told him to just throw them away, but he refused and started wearing them. I pray every day that he doesn't get into an accident because if the paramedics find him in pink underwear, she is a housewife. Without it, what would she have? That's not a job.
I cook, I clean, I garden, I pay the bills, I bring the kids to and from wherever they need to go. Being a mom of two high schoolers is a full-time job.
Why did she even have me if I'm such a burden?
My family is my life. It's a lot of work, but I love being a mom.
And she is such a prude. I go out of my way to dress nice every Sunday for church, and what does she do? She wraps me up in a coat, even in the middle of summer.
I'm sorry, but the Lord does not want to see your thong, your cleavage, or your belly button.
It's not my fault they only make clothes for the skinniest girls in the world.
I don't understand why she only buys clothes in size 0, and sometimes, occasionally, size 2. How could someone be a size 0? Wouldn't that make you invisible?
And don't get me started on her reaction to the tattoo I got. I am only 17, but the guy in the shop didn't even ask me my age. And it's just a tiny claw on my lower back. You can barely see it. But when I came home with it, I could just feel her eyes burning through me. I mean, this is my body. And just because she doesn't have any tattoos and thinks they're ugly, doesn't mean I can't have any. I've had it for over 6 months now, and she refuses to even acknowledge it. Not once has she even asked me that. It's like she doesn't even care.
Thankfully, she hasn't gotten any tattoos. I mean, not yet. I got one when I was her age, but luckily, it's on my lower back, so my shirt covers it. What was I thinking of getting a Devo tattoo? How did I think that band would be timeless? Anyway, when she turns 18, it's her body. She can get a tattoo if she wants. She'll still be my little girl, and I'll still love her. What's the big deal? It's just a tattoo.
We couldn't be more different.
We don't seem to agree on anything.
Her idea of fun is seeing which fabric softener works best.
Her idea of fun is texting over 1,000 times a day. That girl could have written War and Peace just in the last week. We have the unlimited plans.
I can't imagine what she was like as a teenager. Probably the same boring, funny nutty she is today.
I could do without the attitude.
and look out over the beautiful city of Lenox. She would be miserable. An outside cafe? Who would want to go outside when it's so much warmer inside? She would hate it. The Eiffel Tower at night? What a cliche. All the stereotypical tourists do that. I'm telling you, we have nothing in common. Oh no, I forgot to pick up my son from soccer practice. I've been down here for quite a while. I must have really made her mad. I hope she comes and gets me soon. I guess I'll see what's in one of these moldy old boxes. Oh my gosh, I can't believe this. It's my mom's old diary. Dear diary, today I got my first tattoo, and I'm only 16 years old. My parents hate it, but I don't care because I know my favorite band will always be Devo. Who the heck is Devo?
Someone got the better. You guys didn't notice.
What was this?
Last Saturday?
I thought those were nuts.
My throat felt scratchy all weekend. I thought I was catching a cold.
So, what looks good? The turkey, the stuffing, the mashed potatoes.
I don't see that on the menu.
Of course you don't. We're for a nasty Italian restaurant on Thanksgiving.
Will you keep your voice down? We might hear you.
And do what? Kick us out? We're the only people.
Yeah, normal people are at home on Thanksgiving.
We are normal. We just had a bit of an incident. I mean, we had a structure fire.
Come on now. What's the true definition of structure? I mean, really? It's not like I burnt the house down. Just the garage. We don't live in the garage.
My rare action figures in their original boxes and my baseball card collection lived in the garage.
My prom dresses and the family photo albums.
But the rest of the house is fine.
Dripping with water and covered with soot.
Yeah, otherwise, it's fine. I'm so glad you decided to deep fry the turkey this year, honey.
In Dad's defense, it looked pretty cool on YouTube.
I have to admit, it did. The regular Thanksgiving turkey is amazing. But you deep fry anything, it makes it even better.
Yeah, really enjoyed your deep fried joke.
I was experimenting.
My father.
I remember watching that YouTube video, and I remember the warnings that read, do not use frozen turkey. They will explode. And do not place deep fryer next to combustible materials.
How was I supposed to know the garage was combustible?
Alright, I knew it was made of wood.
But those turkeys take forever. I couldn't wait any longer.
I could be at my friend at Alice's house right now. Family has plenty of food. Her dad's not a pyro.
I am not a pyro.
Right. Fireworks on Christmas is a tradition that everybody celebrates. If I remember the story correctly, I believe that the wise men brought baby Jesus gold, frankincense, and bottle rockets.
So I shut off a few Roman candles on the 4th of July and Christmas.
And on Easter, Halloween, and the cat's birthday.
I'm very patriotic.
I have to side with Dad on this one. We're males. It's in our nature. That which is created is meant to be destroyed.
What does that even mean?
It's from a video game.
You're right. We should all live our lives based on the wisdom of video games.
Hey, video games are often closely related to the real world. You're just not open-minded enough to realize the art imitates life.
Yeah. Just let me jump over some barrels, but would have saved a damsel distress from a gorilla. Then I'll bash my head against some bricks so I can eat some mushrooms.
Exactly.
I would have a normal Thanksgiving over at Alex's house.
Do you think I want to be sitting here searching for medical waste in my dinner?
Enough. That is enough. No one is going anywhere. We are going to sit here and have a nice, normal family dinner on this blessed day, or so help me, you will all be grounded.
Even me?
Especially you. So, honey, what looks good?
I think I'll make the pasta.
What about you? If you think the pasta, I mean the anti-pasta.
I think it's...
I know how it's pronounced. As being contrary.
Whoa, now, we talked about the four-syllable words. I'm only a freshman, and...
I'm having an eggplant parmesan.
Just like the Pilgrims.
Well, Columbus was Italian.
Columbus wasn't at the first Thanksgiving.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty certain he was Italian.
incursion is passion for a grand.
I can't live away to you. What's going on?
You know, these fancy restaurants, they like to dim the lights and make them more romantic.
I can't even see my fork.
Why would you need to see your fork? They haven't been browsing any bread.
I got something stuck in my teeth, and I wanted to pick it out.
I wonder why our dental bills are so high.
Any minute now, they'll start playing the romantic Italian music. Oh, so!
No singing!
I'll just want to sit in
food. Forget about setting food. Think they closed the restaurant.
That's ridiculous.
We did have to seat ourselves.
And I had to grab some menus on the way in.
Come to think of it, I don't think I saw a waiter since we got here.
The sign did say open, didn't
it? Well, the lights are on.
Great. No turkey, no pasta. I'm going to starve.
Says the girl who's constantly dieting.
Shut up.
You shut up.
Both of you shut. Simmer down.
I would say my cash is cooking in the parking lot. Maybe I can get some frozen pasta together.
And if not, we can stop at the 7-Eleven. They're always open.
Oh, goody. Slim Jims and Cheetos for Thanksgiving. That reminds me, we haven't all said what we're thankful for. I'll start. I'm thankful for my loving, caring, understanding family. Sweetheart, you go next. I'm thankful that I'll be 18 soon, and I'm going to find a college as far away from this town as possible.
I'm thankful for the dark, so I don't have to see my sister's stupid face.
That's enough! Father, what are you thankful for?
Lost kids.
That's interesting. What are you talking about?
They never saw us come in. They locked the doors. We're stuck.
Stop talking. We only have so much oxygen. You just wasted even more air. Stop it. Stop it. I can't breathe.
Who has a cell phone? I do. Oh, wait. It's in my backpack. In our former garage.
Mine's in the car.
Mine too.
That was
my bad. I wasted it downloading that picture of a band-aid in the ravioli.
Of course, that was before I met your grandfather. It was on the internet.
Yeah, I heard that beauty school in New Jersey.
more Michael Bolton first names in the tri-state area, but you'd be wrong. Of course, I keep myself busy with all the local charities I donate my time to.
Didn't know going to the wine tasting Tuesdays at the local cheese shop was able to show up.
And can't forget about a beautiful purebred dog, Muffins. He's a stray that Mom started feeding. That furry ball Joy sure keeps us on our toes.
He likes to bite, so yeah, I'm often on my toes. That's a shrimp from the box to the front door.
We're thinking of entering him in some local dog shows, but we're not sure how he'd deal with the pressure. Did I mention he's so skittish that every time you try to pet him, he pees a little? I could go on and on.
She would have had anything else going on in her lives.
But I must bid you adieu. Happy holidays, and we hope you have a healthy and prosperous New Year. No, she doesn't. Nothing would make her happy when she's here. Aunt Helen has filed for bankruptcy.
Or just one on the stairs.
Yeah, that big day too. Sincerely, Dr. Janet Statham.
We don't have health insurance, so when something goes seriously wrong, Mom has to play surgeon. Like the time you put that leg over your nose.
Shut up, that was years ago.
You were 13.
I was curious. And James Statham, Esquire.
Dad acted as his own lawyer when he cut down a neighbor's 100-year-old oak tree. He said branches were infringing on our easement.
He lost the case.
Big surprise.
Who pleads insanity over an oak tree?
Our dad, that too.
There. I think that's just about
it. What kind of pine trees?
These ones have a gorgeous photograph of the Yosemite shot by Ansel Adams.
But those are airmail stamps. That's way too much postage for a Christmas card.
What does it matter? Remember, they all think we're rich.
Perfect.
Hey kids, do you want to read this year?
No.
Jeez, what's their problem?
They just need to get into the Christmas spirit. I'll go finish chewing up those Christmas lights.
And I'll get the ace bandages and rubbing alcohol ready.
All about that stuff, and I got all the information I need to know.
What did they tell you?
you.
If I have a question, I'll ask.
Good!
Fine.
God, we could have the talk.
That wasn't the talk, but I don't need the talk. This is nothing to talk about.
If I had a nickel for every time I saw someone as beautiful as you, I'd have 5 cents. Do you believe in love at first sight, or should I walk by again? I'm glad I got my library card. Why? Because I'm totally checking you out.
Stop it now.
What? I'm telling you, ladies love a good pickup line. I just want to show this rose how incredibly beautiful you are.
Have you ever got mom to date you, let alone marry you? It's totally beyond me.
She couldn't resist Le Tigre.
Hey, what?
Le Tigre!
What the heck is that?
That was my nickname in high school.
There's no way, not a million years, has anyone ever called you that.
I was a predator, and the ladies were my prey.
Can't we just watch the game?
Yeah, the tiger in the jungle is a way better analogy. See, son, like a tiger, you got claws. And with great power comes great responsibility.
Now you're quoting Spider-Man, I'm leaving.
Wait! I'm sorry. It's just, you've been on the phone so much lately, and you know you like your test, even in church. And the other week, you came home all puffy face and teary-eyed. I was just afraid someone had broken your heart. And believe me, I've broken so many in my time, I was stealing for you, dog.
I'm too busy ice skating, keeping up with my grades, and hanging out friends and bottoms with the girl. Frankly, I like being free.
You don't gotta play tough with me. We saw that you're crying. You wanna talk about it? I don't know. You know how much I love my key, huh?
I don't.
I swear on Bessie.
Thank you, Kia.
Why were you crying?
Bessie?
Can we get on with this?
Alright. My friend Billy's dad is a cop. And since he's a cop, he's got pepper spray just lying around the house. Me and my friends decided to go to Taco Bell to get some burritos. The guy, the drive-thru guy, forgot to put hot sauce in the back. We got back to Billy's house, looked in the fridge, no hot sauce. You can't have a burrito with no hot sauce, so we
sprayed pepper spray on your burrito?
Yeah, not a good idea.
You don't say!
Yeah, that's what I was already about to.
Do you know how dangerous?
You only turn 16 once, and as far as birthdays go, it's a big one. I mean, you can finally drive. You're halfway through high school. Only 2 more years until I can get to the clubs. Well, some of the clubs. 5 more years until I can get to all the clubs. Not that my town really has any clubs, but you know what I'm saying. Turning 16 is probably the most important thing that will ever happen. So when my parents told me that I could have a sweet 16 party and that they would pay for it, I thought I'd died and gone to heaven. I had it all planned out. We'd run out my favorite restaurant, La Chic, and out of my 50 of my closest friends. Well, 30 of my closest. 20 girls I don't really like, you know, just to make them jealous. We'd have rosé, cheesecake, sparkling cider, and real champagne glasses. I wrote it all down and gave instructions to my mom over a year ago. But now that my birthday has finally come, I don't think they fully comprehend the true vision of my plan.
Welcome, party girls, and also welcome to our local Black Men's Club. Sorry about the mix-up. Somehow, we dealt with the fishing game off. But no worries, there's plenty room to go around. And who doesn't love his music, am I right?
We are so glad you can all share this special day with us. We know our little sweetheart has been looking forward to turning 16 for quite some time, and this party is our gift to her. After a lot of hard work and planning, this party is our way of showing Brittany just how much we love her.
Just don't hold back on the line much. There's plenty more to go around.
And if we do run out, there's an emergency supply of free sends out in the car.
Ooh, classy, juice vessel. This is a special day.
And sure is.
Now, we can't move forward until I get across to the list of food. Is wine the best half cook in town or what?
Oh, stop it.
I mean, where else are you?
Chipped in Tulsa, all in the same place. I'll tell you where. No way. Because this isn't your everyday store event. No, today my big girl turns 16.
And don't think we forgot about the entertainment. The basement booth is out in the parking lot, and Sparky the Clown is making his way through there and making a balloon. You can choose between a poodle, a giraffe, or even a hat.
Wow, this is exciting. But that's not all. Brady Zuckerberg Jeff has put together something pretty special. Allow me to introduce the amazing Jeffrey.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I am the amazing Jeffrey. Thank you. I need a volunteer. What is your name, young lady?
Don't be stupid. I've been putting up with your crap ever since I was 3, and my life was ruined the moment I came home from the hospital with you.
Oh, a feisty one. Not gonna give me your name, huh? I guess I'm gonna have to use the power of my mind.
For the love.
Now give me a second. Where did my mind at? It looks like a bee.
Brittany. My name is Brittany.
That's the very name I had in my mind's eye.
That's amazing.
Isn't he so good?
Thank you. Now that I have my volunteer, I'm gonna make her disappear. All I have to do is say the magic words. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata. Words on a dog. I got the instructions here. I point the wand, check. Push the button on the bottom, check. A big puff of smoke comes out, and then, just something Korean. Well, at least I think that's Korean.
The amazing Jeffrey.
Give me a minute.
I'm a magician. Hello.
Movie girl, now's the time we'd like to share a few kiddish stories with our beautiful dog.
That's right. You know, our little girl is Brittany. But we only moved to this lovely town a couple of years ago, so most of you missed out on her childhood.
Not to mention awkward junior high years.
There's a treasure of stories about Brittany. Things that outlandish friends don't know about. Dear God, it's me, Brittany. Please make this stop, and I promise I will never, ever do a single bad thing again for the rest of my life. Amen.
Did you know that Brittany used to wear headgear? It's true. Her teeth were so crooked, you spotted her a little carny.
And there's this one time at Christmas when she was bad. No.
The spotted all so badly.
Don't you dare. Weeks and weeks. And that Christmas morning? If you continue, I'll hire a lawyer and become an emancipated minor. I swear on my life.
She opened a present from Santa, and there's that Barbie doll.
And that's it. That's the end of the story. Enjoy the party, everyone. She was so excited when she saw the Barbie that she paid herself. And that's why we call her Brittany Peepay. Enough! Seriously, who are you people? Why did you become my parents? Just to ruin my life? You're horrible, horrible individuals, and I'll never forgive you for—
Hakuna Matata! Aloha!
Honey, our son is on fire. Put him out. Well, while we get things situated backstage, I put together a special video for all of you. If you could please dim the lights. 16 years ago, I gave birth to the beautiful girl we are all honoring today. And what better way to relive that miracle than to relive it together? I present the birth of my daughter. Enjoy. No!
Those things on its lips, but I want to share a drink with you in case you're infected with mouth blisters.
Just saying.
He does not have mouth muscles.
Actually, honey, he does need to start wearing some chapstick. He's always picking at my skin, and
I am not having this conversation.
So, sweetheart, what are you going to do on this trip? Pray
that she doesn't get mouth muscles.
Drive! Just drive!
You see that?
What? Where?
Right there, in the bushes.
I don't see anything.
I look like a troll.
Good job.